I'm Rebecca Kennard, and this is Cameron, and we're going to make a ride in helicopter. So what you're going to do is take the waist part of your helicopter, it's a 260, blow it the whole way up, let a little puff of air out of it, and tie the ends together. Then we're going to make the arm part. Take two 260s, blow them up the whole way, let a little puff of air out, and then take, let's ignore these other balloons. Go with your ring on your waist part of your helicopter, tie the ends together, get your two red ones, I'm going to use red for this, twist off a cherry tomato sized bubble, wrap it around the crease where you tied your waist one together, and then take the other matching red 260 and about a hand's length up, twist it, and twist off another cherry tomato sized bubble. Go like this, and about from your elbow to your wrist, down here, go up about that far, and you're going to twist these together, right like that. And then you're going to go down here, and from about your elbow to your wrist, measure that, you're going to twist this, and you're going to go up. About a hand's length in between. Try to get this the same size, okay? Wrap it around. Do the same thing with this one. Elbow to your wrist. Twist it around. Go up, try to get it about the same length. Doesn't matter, it could be a little off. Twist it around. So you have something that looks like this. And then you're gonna go to the end here and you're gonna fold it. Pinch this like this to make your little handles for them to fly their helicopter around. And here, do the same thing. Go down about a hand length. Pinch it like this to shape it. And you're going to go up, let's see, probably from your hand, from your wrist to your elbow. Out like that. Twist that around. You can, if you want to, you can put a pinch twist in here. It kind of holds everything together, but you don't have to. But I like to put a pinch twist right here at the base. And just kind of tuck it under. It holds everything together like this. And then you get yourself a 160, blow it up the whole way and tie the ends together. Now you don't have to have this 160 propeller on the back if you're in a hurry, but it's just kind of a nice little added thing. You just put three equal loops in it. They don't have to be exactly equal. You get the idea. And then make a little bubble at the top here. Twist this around. You can kind of make them look more sharp like a propeller if you want. And then take a 260, blow it up the whole way. Stretch it out if you can. You can also take three 260s, blow them up the whole way, and you can make three here. But I'm just doing it with one 260 to show you if you have a long line and you're in a hurry. It's a faster way. Try to make these the same length. You can pinch the ends to make them look more like blades. Twist a little bubble. Twist this around. And there's your ride-in helicopter. And then you find yourself a little dude like Cameron. And you put your arms in and put your arms out to the sides. And then he's going to show you how to fly it.